USR Rescue Specialist Certificate is the highest level of training a rescue specialist can get in their field. It signifies a tremendous amount of knowledge, skills, and abilities that the student has attained over the course of months, or in some cases years, coming down here and taking courses at TEKS. This is something worthy of recognizing the accomplishments that these responders are able to meet and the commitment they have to their job. So once they accomplish it, it truly is something that's remarkable. The USR Rescue Specialist Certificate is designed for people that work on an urban search and rescue team or a specialized rescue team. It's 304 hours worth of training that they have to complete. Half of the certificate, the training has to take place here at Disaster City. They have to have the ropes rescue 1 and 2 or technician. They have to have the 80-hour structural collapse course. Then they have to take the Advanced Structural Collapse 3, which is Advanced Exterior Shoring, the Advanced Structural Collapse 4, which is Advanced Interior, and the Advanced Structural Collapse 5, which is Advanced Breaching and Breaking. They take those three classes and also one elective. That equals 304 hours of training. They will then get their USR Rescue Specialist Certificate from TEKS.
Advanced 3 class was advanced shoring, where we did a three-story shore. People were anchored off of actual ropes up three stories up in the air.
When we build them in the initial technician class, everything's perfect 90 degree, flat walls. Now you get into the environment, more realistic of what you're going to see in the field with disaster debris and stuff like that around the building.
Structural Collapse 4, we got to crawl through tunnels and shore that. My favorite was the lace post box, using big 6x6s hanging from rope and putting on all your cross bracing, and that was a lot of fun.
We were underneath the rubble pile, shoring as we went, crawling through holes that were about the size of my shoulders and being able to wiggle through like you'd have to do in the real world.
The magnitude of the class, the magnitude of the shoring system was fabulous.
When you walk up to the building after a disaster or a hurricane, you're not looking at the building at four walls. You're looking how the building sits on each other, what happens when Mother Nature goes onto these buildings and what could cause, because it's a hazard for us. We're taught down here to look at that building in a different way.
ASC 5 is advanced breaching and breaking of steel and concrete, lowering systems, hauling of tools, and then using the pneumatics, the hydraulics, and electric tools, all while breaching the steel and the concrete, stuff that it's really hard to duplicate other than here at TEKS.
Climbing down a wall on a rappel is one thing. Climbing down on a rappel and bouncing off of it with a breaker bar in your hand is something totally different. It makes you stop and think about how you can utilize different tools and different slings and make the tool work better for you.
I learned a bunch of different ways how to support the buildings, different nail patterns, you know, what holds a certain amount of weight. So I took a lot out of that.
One of the good classes that we were able to take was the passenger rail class. That's our cup of tea. That's what we do every single day.
They had us going down in ravines recovering bodies, which we do on a regular basis when we have train strikes. The actual nighttime exercise was phenomenal, having to lower them from all different angles, using tripods, thinking on the spot, and just working with the different groups of people that were here for the rail specialist.
This is stuff that you really have to learn, because when you're out in the field, you have to make the judgment calls on your own. You don't always have somebody looking over your shoulder. You really have to have that background, that experience, to make those in-the-field decisions when time is critical and you don't have any other resources to rely upon at the time.
You really have to have a plan in place. So you have to do team building and come up with a plan, implement that plan, whether it's exterior or interior. It just shows how much teamwork it takes to get things done and accomplished in a timely manner, in a safe manner.
To be able to accomplish this and actually receive a certificate at the end of it is just a proud moment to, you know, show that, you know, a lot of hard work was put into this and a lot of people that supported me to be here and allow me to complete the series.
We think that this is going to be something that jurisdictions all over the country are going to want to send their best down here to take this. Very few people in the nation and in the world have achieved this level of advanced training.
This is something I never dreamed would happen. I'm going to be the first person to do something like this in the state. It's pretty neat. I'm pretty proud.
Being the first female is a big accomplishment for me, and I hope it inspires other females to do the same.
I've got a document that shows that I really have done this over the long haul. It's something that very few of these people that are in the rescue business have at this time.
It's something I never dreamed of 10 years ago when I started in the New Jersey Transit as a police officer. To be actually being come to Texas to do this training at this facility is more than I could even imagine. You actually smile inside knowing that this is something that you accomplished in your career.